counterfeiting afflicts trade worldwide and is having more impact on economies and jobs than ever. The European Union's figures on fake goods seized almost doubled in 2005-2006. It's their bread and butter for customs at Roissy Airport in Paris. It's not mission impossible for the freight targeting cell. Of all the fakes nabbed here, they find more than half. We are entering a highly restricted zone where cargo for France or destined to be sent on is spot checked. 8,000 tons come into Roissy every day, one of the biggest volumes in Europe of legitimate imports or otherwise. The massive increase in knockoffs has also vastly diversified.
Most of the counterfeits are from China and Hong Kong. What we find among the products is a lot of jewelry. But with the evolution of the business, we've gone from luxury products, which have been the mainstay of the counterfeiters, I'd say, to faking regular consumer goods. That could be MP3 players, USB keys, all sorts of things like that now can be counterfeit.
Items in high demand are often aimed at young buyers who aren't aware of the impact the fakes industry has on trade internationally.
What's special about this one here is that there's no Apple symbol nor the word iPod. Only the appearance is copied, which in itself constitutes a counterfeit. One small touch worth noting, you'll see it says the European norms are respected, marked here.
This kind of Alibaba's cave is where all the seized counterfeits are stored. They're waiting to be destroyed. High street products next to items which, if they were real, would fetch astronomical prices.
This watch is a rather a clumsy imitation of a Rolex. It's a well-known model, but this watch is a relatively poor likeness. In this hall, all these boxes right here, there are about 4,000 watches. The authentic value on that would be close to 50 million euros.
EU estimates for 2004 found the counterfeit racketeers were dealing at levels of around 500 billion euros. That was 7 to 10% of the volume of total world trade. Since less than 5% of the goods coming into the European market are checked, that's considered fair cause to worry. In 2007, year-on-year customs seizures in the EU rose by 17%. More than 79 million pirated items were stopped at the member states' borders. There's been a more than 50% increase in illicit medical drugs, and cosmetics saw a 264% rise. These are the sort of fakes that seriously threaten people's health.
Here's yet another load from China headed for Africa. It was declared as clothing and footwear. In fact, there are shoes wrapped in newspaper. When we open them up, we find a brand name. So we'll look at that and check on it further. We'll be able to hold back this type of product. We call that a community holding. It lets us block the merchandise for 10 days.
If an item is confirmed as non-authentic, it's destroyed. The EU customs program supports coordinated work between the member states' customs, as well as those of Croatia and Turkey, to fight the counterfeit trade. The European Parliament is also studying what countermeasures can be taken by the source countries outside the EU, exploring the global impact and proposing a European authority to manage this.
Europe needs an overseeing authority, an observatory, with the authority to act over each member state's central authority in the fight against counterfeiting. The customs system has to be reinforced, the means harmonized to produce the international tools with which to fight counterfeiting.
The Parliament's members agree that the world's most powerful trade bloc needs stronger action against the pirated goods business, but not everyone thinks a European authority is the form it should take.
In the customs practice, everyday practice, more people have to be involved in detecting, in really take action and come up with measures. So I believe very much in improving the situation in the member states, customs authorities, police organizations, justice, that they act and they respond, because that can be really effective, not a big office with a lot of officials in it.
There's also the involvement of the consumers. They are, after all, the intended buyers of the illegal merchandise. The European Consumers Bureau says there must be no room for doubt.
It's very clear that if you buy a 5-euro t-shirt with a crocodile on it on the beach in the Côte d'Azur or in some market, you're an accomplice to theft. You can't miss that it's a counterfeit. But things are more complicated when you get consumers who buy fake products without knowing it. In the past few years, we've found the market is shifting from luxury products into mass consumption like mobile phones and products for computers, cars or even aircraft.
Comme les voitures, les automobiles, ou même comme les avions.
Some people justify counterfeiting, saying it meets a demand. The person who buys a fake might know it's against the law, and yet it's becoming more socially acceptable. People might admit openly to owning an imitation, though in certain circles, they'll want to avoid it or keep it a secret. It's a risk to consider.
Most people pay the price. It's the perverse side of capitalism. People always look for the cheapest things.
I think purchasing power pushes people to buy fakes. If everyone had the money to buy the genuine thing, it wouldn't work. The price rules, certainly today. Wallets first, then we'll see.
Financial and legal aspects have an important place in the analysis of the counterfeit market, but one of the most persuasive arguments may not be the knock-off effect on people's jobs. According to official estimates, the selling of fake articles has prevented the creation of some 200,000 jobs. Substandard machine parts are a danger, as are bogus medicines and cosmetics. The anti-counterfeit arguments are strong. Would you buy anything fake? Have you? 40% of people questioned in a recent survey said they would.